He was a friend. And we talked often because we shared our passion for Norwood.
A big heart with big money, but Carl Lindner never forgot where he came from. Tonight, friends, peers, and employees share their stories of what Carl Lindner meant to them and this city.
Well, his name is just about everywhere you look around this city. Carl Lindner built a business empire of baseball banks and bananas and much more.
And he also touched the lives of almost everyone he met. News 5's John London begins our live team coverage tonight. John.
Yeah, Lisa, those who speak of Carl Lindner tonight are doing so with a high degree of respect and a lot of gratitude. He did a lot in this community, as most people know, and one look at the skyline gives you sort of an imprint of Carl Lindner's hand. It's a view that he loved, according to those who knew and worked with him often.
It is perhaps a measure of how much of a mark he has made here when just about everybody's talking about the Lindner legacy.
Being a self-made man, accomplishing all the things he accomplished, he never left Cincinnati, never left the commitment that he had to Cincinnati.
One scan of the city skyline tells you that. Great American Ballpark, home to the team he once owned. In its shadow, the Freedom Center, to which he was an initial contributor. Although Lindner's political and business connections stretched to the White House and world capitals, he never broke with his Norwood roots.
And I said, Mr. Lindner, I saw you driving down the street the other day. He's like, well, you know, I still get my hair cut there, and I like to drive around on Sundays and just see the old neighborhood.
Sitting with Chip Gerhardt a few hours after Lindner's death, he talked about how genuinely down-to-earth he was and how Norwood would feel the loss profoundly.
90% was for the kids. Our community center, I met him in Sandy over there. He walked through the community center, talked to our seniors, wanted to do something there. So it was always Norwood and the kids.
Lindner presided over billions in assets. His political influence was formidable to his dying day. Sheriff Lease knew him well and shared with us what Lindner felt in his heart.
He loved this city. Everything he did was for the benefit of the city. You bring the companies into town.
I think he still believed that he was a blessed man and that this can only happen in America. Somebody like him could be as successful and as impactful as he has been.
Only in America. Those were the words inscribed on his cufflinks and on motivational cards that he would pass out from time to time. So much is known about his accomplishments and his backstory, but at 5:30 we will take you to one of his lesser-known accomplishments. We'll take you right inside the Freedom Center for that. Reporting live downtown, John London, News 5.
John, thank you. You know, Carl Lindner Jr., the billionaire, came from humble roots, and he leaves behind a legacy unparalleled here in Cincinnati's history. Jack is joining us now with a look back at his life. Jack?
Sherry, Mr. Lindner's impact on our community is as broad as the smiles you see at every UDF counter and as towering as the Great American Tower at Queen City Square. Its grand opening was the last time we saw him in public.
Carl Lindner Jr. always wanted the tri-state to strive constantly to be bigger and better, a point he made clear to us at his last public appearance, the grand opening of the Great American Tower.
We wanted the building 1 inch taller than the Crew Tower.
One of his sons told us at the time, it's not just about image. It's about being leaders in the community and about giving back.
I'm proud of as much of anything when you look back, as you said, during this the Great Recession here, that this building offered so many jobs, you know, over the past couple years. And, you know, it was such a boost to the local economy and to many families.
His own beginnings couldn't have been more modest. Born in 1919, 14-year-old Carl had to drop out of school to help run his family's ice cream store in Norwood when his dad became ill. The young man who made pre-dawn milk runs went on to become one of the richest men in the world, with business assets that he reckoned were worth $14 billion. They included, at various times, United Dairy Farmers, Great American Insurance Company, Chiquita Bananas, the Cincinnati Enquirer, and the Cincinnati Reds that he bought from Marge Schott.
So this is just a little token from...
Get a load of this. It's a star. From another star. Thank you, honey. Thank you.
Mr. Lindner was a shy man, a devout Baptist who didn't smoke, drink, or swear. His charitable giving ran into the tens of millions and included founding Cincinnati Hills Christian Academy, the Lindner Family Tennis Center in Mason, and the Lindner Center of Hope, a treatment center for people with mental health problems.
In all, the donations reached astronomical levels. He gave roughly $60 million in just one 10-year period that we know of, but his smaller acts of kindness touched a lot of us, too. Lisa?
Thanks, Jack. And more examples of Carl Linder's big heart come from comments left on our Facebook page. Gail writes, "When I moved here years ago and started work at Fort Hamilton, I went to my first Reds game on tickets Mr. Lindner gave to us employees. I thought, what a city to have someone so generous living there." Verity adds, "You were my Cincinnati Reds Santa Claus when I was in grade school, and I will always thank you for those tickets. It meant a lot to me. Thank you for caring."
And House Speaker John Boehner also paying tribute tonight, saying Carl Lindner was a good friend, an entrepreneur, a job creator who truly loved Cincinnati. Never a man to turn down a worthy cause. Carl's generosity touched countless lives.